Yeah. play for you this evening. And with this song comes a story. They don't all have stories, but this one has one. About 20 years ago, 25 years ago, I moved out to Los Angeles in search of fame and fortune. And at the time, all I got was the word no.
Nope.
What are you doing here? You don't have an appointment. You have a weird last name. And you play blues and rock, and nobody likes blues and rock. Okay, whatever. Like I'm the fucking music executive that said it to me. You know? Use the imagination. But there was one gentleman who befriended me when I first moved out there, and his name was Will Jennings. And he's written so many songs by people that you know. Eric Clapton, the song Tears in Heaven, he wrote that with him. Up Where We Belong, Joe Cocker, Jennifer Warrens, Back in the High Life again with Steve Winwood, Roll With It, you know, this goes on and on. And he liked me for some reason. And I remember going to his house one day in Agoura Hills, and he said, you know, Joe, today will be our last day riding together because I'm officially retiring as of tomorrow. And I said, wow, Will, what happened? Why are you retiring? And he goes, well, metaphorically, Joe, my ship has finally come in after 40 years of writing songs. And he says, 6 months ago, I was asked to write some lyrics to a big old-fashioned ballad that was going into a movie about a ship that sailed from England. And the movie was called Titanic. And the song was being sung by, in his words, not mine, some Canadian chick. He's from Texas. He can get away with that. And we wrote two songs that day. We wrote that song, Woke Up Dreaming, that I just got done playing for you. I hope you enjoyed that one. And we wrote this next song, and I learned two lessons that day. Because My Heart Will Go On was the biggest selling single, I think it still is, of all time, back when you can actually sell records, not give them away for free. And I learned two lessons that day. I learned one, all good things do come to an end, regardless of your best intentions, so you might as well get up in the morning, or in my case today, the afternoon, and live your life to the fullest, because you never know when something's gonna come to an end. The most important lesson I learned that day, I learned for the first time as a 23-year-old man what the sight of someone who had just become what you can best be described as fuck you rich looks like. The dude was lighting his cigarettes with $100 bills. So the second song we wrote that afternoon was the last song I ever wrote with him. It seems to be the most popular around these parts, especially in this theater at this very moment. This one here is called Mountain Time. Thank you very much for coming. The kid.